we are test driving a Lucid today.
All
right. Look at that. Nice. Sexy mama. Lucid Air. There you go.
Feels like one of those motel beds on Route 66, but I kind of like it.
Seatbelt's on.
Yep. Seatbelt on, Fareed, I can tell.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah,
that's any modern car.
You might need to use the other enter.
Oh my god.
Well, the one thing I could say, the accelerator pedal actually has decent feel to it. It doesn't feel video gamey like an on-off switch, which is really nice. You get that on a lot of EVs, but this actually... Oh yeah, you can one pedal this thing all day.
Yep, it's pretty cool.
I kind of like how in standard regen mode, it still kind of feels traditional when coming to a stop. That's very, very nice.
Yeah, that's because he's got it on the... Well, put it on the high one. It'll stop back there.
Okay, if you're tall, these aren't the greatest sun visors, but they do work.
There we go. All right.
Handles well.
I have you on sport mode right now.
Oh, lovely. This manages its weight very well. That does not. Okay, lane keep assist. You are interacting just a bit much. I wasn't even out of the bloody lane.
Oh, just that bump right there. Yeah, it did to me too. It was like, yeah, no. I was like, I didn't even do nothing.
And my butt's nice and cool too, because the cool seat's on.
Oh yeah, it's fine.
No, that's fine. That part's fine. It's hot today. Yeah. This is very, very nice. It's very intuitive. What else? I'll try it in the smooth mode, just because we are where we are. And where do you adjust the regen again? You have to press and hold, I see. Remember when I first drove the Rivian, the standard regen mode was like more than enough, and then, yeah, the standard regen mode in the Rivian's aggressive. You put it in the high, it's even more aggressive. But I get why some people would like that, and it is a pickup truck. It does sit a little bit higher, you know. This is designed to be, you know, a touring sedan. Now this part I do like, that my Rivian will not have, vents that I can use with toggles.
Oh, what does a Rivian use?
Screen. Everything's through the screen in a Rivian,
but
everything.
Even like vents?
Even that's through the screen.
Really? How does that work?
Same thing with everything else, you sit there and mess with it before you leave, because you have to. I mean...
Wow.
Clearly that was a marketing decision in my perspective. But, you know, you look at cars from 20 years ago, they have things in there that were just kind of unheard of at the time. Honestly, all I ever really want out of a car, especially for climate control, whenever you turn the temperature up or down, if you turn it all the way down to low, it doesn't immediately kick the fan speed on. Because Land Rovers do that, and it drives me nuts. You know, I just want to turn the temperature down, not increase the fan speed. Let me increase the fan
speed. It does that automatically.
It does it automatically. Okay, this
my,
you can...
My Volvo does that.
Exactly. And Volvo makes a great car. My Mercedes does that. The older one and the newer one, they all do it. It's just... Okay, this is more the one pedal that I'm used to in an EV.
Got it.
This... It is a little aggressive, but in town, I think you get used to it. Like, a lot of people don't like it. My aunt doesn't like that on her Prius. My uncle does. So, me personally, I think the whole point of an EV, especially if you're using it in the city, you want to use the regen. Yeah, this makes life easy. I don't have to move my foot that much. Oh, this is very smooth. This thing on a road trip, oh my goodness. Drive this down to Florida, it'd be great. Or to California or wherever.
Yeah, exactly.
Handles well. Steering's fairly light for, you know, a luxury car. It's about typically what you'd expect. It's got decent feedback.
It sounds smooth.
Yeah.
Go up to sprint, it'll give it a stiffer feel.
Yeah, but for, this is kind of what I would call acceptable for a luxury car, but I know where the front wheels are.
Yeah.
I don't feel like, the lane keep assist is a little aggressive because I'm not getting out of this lane, but it thinks I am, but that's something you can turn off.
Okay.
So, but it feels very confident. It I don't feel like, you know, the front end's wandering all over the place. The back end follows around fairly nicely. It manages its weight very well for what it is, because it is a heavy car.
It's over 5,000.
Oh yeah. Well, I got an old S class. I got an old, no, what do I got? It's an E class. I have an old E class, but it's a really old E class and a cheap car that I bought because I couldn't help myself. And that thing weighs over 6,000 pounds. And it floats like it's old school.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, this doesn't
air
do
suspension?
That. Not air suspension, believe it or not. It's actually got hydraulic suspension on it. Believe it or not, because it's 90s technology. It was just a nice. I've always liked them, the older Mercs. When you find a one that's nice, that's in really good condition, they're cheap.
Yeah.
I just couldn't help myself, basically. And when I drive down in the city, if I'm just by myself, I'll drive that car because it's quiet and comfortable, but it's so old and dinged up, nobody looks at it twice. I don't have to worry about it getting broken into. I can park it anywhere, I don't care, but it drives nice. It looks like a, you know, knackered old car, but underneath, everything functions the way it should for the time. But this, living with this is just amazing. I have driven a Model S. This is better. This is night and day better than a Model S. Model S is not right if you like it, but with the architecture on this, the charging speed on this, I mean, for around the same money, I don't know how you have to at least look at this, in my opinion. I love the design of this. It's beautiful. It's got real leather in it, too. That's even better. And the accelerator pedal lets you know, hey, I'm an accelerator pedal, you have to press me. It's not, this doesn't do everything for you like I thought it was going to do, honestly.
I'm writing down what you said, because that's, I want to have my boss know.
Oh, please, I'd be happy to give you feedback.
You mentioned that the Lucid is a night and day comparison to the Tesla.
Well, I haven't driven the Plaid. I've driven an older Model S, but the Model S to me is just a dated product in this market, in this segment. This is getting to be very competitive. You know, I like the way the back ride's better than the EQS. I really do. And this is made in America, which, I mean, that alone gets my attention. Because nothing against European or Asian manufactured cars. I just like American-made cars. But this doesn't do everything for you. You actually still have to drive this. Yes, it has some safety features in it. It has a lot of tech in it. I respect that. Yeah. But
it's not meant to drive you.
No, I don't want a car. I don't want a car that I'd get a chauffeur. I would get a Maybach and hire a chauffeur if that's what I wanted. I like to drive.
Still be chauffeured in this, though.
You could do. You could do. You absolutely could do in this. Good storage throughout. I mean, it's just, it feels well put together. I have not heard any creaks or rattles in this car at all, even with the stereo off. I didn't hear anything in the back, which is a big problem I had with Tesla. The build quality isn't there. This does not have that problem. I mean, I've seen a couple of these with panel gap issues, but, you know, that's an easy fix. Want me to put it back in the spot or just pull it to the curb?
You can pull up in front where this white curb on the right is, and then I'll park it.
I mean, this really is a dream to drive. It really is fantastic. And I'm not somebody who likes EVs, but this is great. This is beautiful. This is a hard car to say no to. It really is.
Charging port here. The passengers in the back have a shade that is activated right now, so they can be protected. It's the very back window.
Yeah.
The seats can be adjusted here. There's 8-way adjustments, or you can use a control on the side of the left. Passenger adjustment. And then you have a...
sitting in here for 20 minutes trying to...
massage setting.
And here's the best part. Since there is no transmission tunnel back here, you can, like, literally spread eagle back here if you got the back seat to yourself, so it's very comfortable.
This is your ambient lighting. There's light strips in the interior that you can change, and then your charging page. This will give you 516 miles on a full charge.
Oh, it moves too. Oh my god.
Are you okay with it, or should I turn it off?
You might want to turn it off. You can just sit in the seat back and look at the sun, man, and just, wow. Yeah.
The seats up front have heated ventilation and heated steering wheel. The seats in the back have heat. And then there's a 360 camera.
The camera technology is amazing on this.
Yeah, that's pretty dope.
It's actually better than the Rivian. It really is.
Wireless charging for your phone, and then there's 21 speakers on this one. It's a Dolby Atmos sound system.
Dolby Atmos. Does it have CarPlay?
It's in California or Arizona.
Whenever you're ready, you're going to pull this lever down.
This one?
Yep.
All the way. Do I need to?
Yes, you do. There you go. Press down. All the way.
All the way down.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Okay.
Now, this also has hill hold assist brakes, so when you're stopped, that's going to engage automatically, just like it did on the Rivian.
Yeah.
So, just remember that.
You're going to make a left out of here, and then a left on the south side. It'll stop on its own. It won't roll. It won't coast.
Yeah,
because
okay.
Of the regenerative braking.
Gotcha.
This is actually the first time he has ever driven an electric car, and he's driving one of the most advanced, newest things on the market right now. But this is also one of the best drivers I've ever known. Comes from 20 years of driving a truck. Not crashy at all back here.
I mean, it is very...
It's very smooth back here. Like I said, I've been in these, but I've never driven one, never been a passenger in one. I've just gotten to sit in them, so...
Got it.
Quality of materials in here is excellent.
Is
this
leather or...
This is the real leather, yeah. There's Alcantara leather. You have...
As much as I like the interior on the Rivian that I got coming, I do. The one thing I don't like is that they don't offer real leather, because you can feel it, you can smell it in here. Like, I have an old Mercedes, and that's why I like it, because it has real leather like this. My man here is just loving this, and I know he is. Yep, there's the regen.
This bad boy is not playing around.
Nope.
It comes to a stop. Like, I literally do not have to touch the brake. It's just Abbott that I'm doing it.
Yeah. Now look at this. There's even little USB-C ports in the stowage compartment back here, so it's massive for the rear of a console, and it's got USB-Cs in it. That's actually a really nice little touch. Because apparently you cannot put children in a car anymore without giving them a tablet or some kind of electronic device.
That's the day and age that we live in now.
It is, but we all grew up in a time where we didn't have those things. Well, yeah, but when we were kids, we didn't have that. We used to have to come up and make up games to play on the road.
Oh, now we're talking.
it's very smooth back here.
There's suspension on this one.
I know this would be expensive. I know this would be an expensive car to buy for an Uber, but it'd be a hell of a nice Uber if I ever got picked up by one.
Standard or high? So this one you're going to coast a little bit more.
Okay, high. Yeah.
A lot of people like the high regen, the one pedal in town. I kind of have to agree.
I just wanted to see what it was.
Yeah.
What that one was like because it's
kind of
smooth.
Well, you remember in the Rivian, the standard one that we... when we tried, it seemed hard enough. Then they're like, no, it's got a higher mode. It doesn't need it. I mean, this thing has easily enough room, if not more room, than an S-Class in the back. Just a standard S-Class, not the Maybach, but there's plenty of room back here to just really be comfortable. I'm 6'4", so...
And I'm extended at 6 foot.
Yeah. So,
like, I might be able to go an inch hot back, but show you this music system. One of my favorite features. I love loud music. I'm not sure about the rest.
Oh, now you're talking his language.
What do you drive now?
2005 Scion XP.
Oh wow, a Scion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we've been trying to grow a company, and the way you do that is to save money. So you keep the old beaters on the road, you know.
Hey, if it gets you from A to B, there's nothing wrong with that.
It's still.
But I'm saying, wow, a Scion, because I haven't seen the Scion in a while.
Yeah, I know.
I have one at home that I bought new when I was 20. I just turned 39 a few months ago. I still own it, so it's been a very, very good car, and I stopped driving it every day years ago, but I couldn't bear to get rid of it. It wasn't worth getting rid of, honestly. So I just kept it. And that's my special occasion, you know. You know, I want memory lane, I go drive that car. I mean, even Gordon Murray still has a Miata that he bought new when he was 19. And if you ask him, what's the last car in the world you're ever gonna drive, last tank of fuel, he'll say that, so. And, you know, cheap, clapped out Japanese car is good enough for him. It's good enough for me. You know. But, you know, we're getting into the space where we'll be able to make some moves and maybe treat ourselves, indulge a little bit, you know.
Yeah,
so,
take some time.
You know, it does take some time. And, you know, I've actually been curious about this, too, because I love the way it looks, but I've never actually driven one. And I've just sat in them, but back here, I could fall asleep back here on a long trip. Instead of this window, they should have a pillow here, like in a Toyota Century. That's a, you know. Oh, this is soft enough. Let's see. Okay, I'm tall enough. That works.
And then if you pull up your button twice, your window button.
Yep, that's a shade.
Yep.
Oh yeah. Once again, everyone does what Mercedes does, because Mercedes was the first one to really do this a long time ago, but for good reason, because it's lovely. Oh yeah, that's a lot more shade when you have them all up back here, definitely.
Do you have the one in the back?
Yeah.
it's like CEOs in the background.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. The only thing I'm missing is my Japanese tape recorder like I have in my Century. Just... They have that technology. It's very expensive. Ferraris have had that for a while, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Ferrari 612 Scaglietti, if you get it with the big glass roof, it's got a dimmer in it. You can just, either can be completely clear, black, or somewhere in between. It's got like four settings on it. My uncle had one, so. They got the right tunes for you, Fareed.
I could have, yeah. I that was yesterday, now today's album.
Yeah.
Left here. Yeah.
That's my mom's favorite band, actually. My mom loves ABBA.
Good music. Feel good music, you know?
It is that. It is that. It's never been my favorite band, but it makes my mom happy, so that's all I care about. Same as on the Rivian.
That light is clearly red. I'm like, where are you finna go?
Oh, it down here in Buckhead, traffic lights are like guidelines. The same in New Jersey, you know? We suggest that you stop here, but you don't really have to, because that's how people drive. It's a great thing that you guys have gotten your order times down along with everybody else, because, you know, it creates a lot of American jobs in this country, and that's something we can all be proud of as far as I'm concerned.
I agree.
I'm really enjoying seeing manufacturing coming back to this country, especially when it comes to cars.
Yeah, business and jobs for sure.
Oh, absolutely. We'll find out in a little bit if the front seat is as good as the back, but I'm assuming it will be. Full 90 degree. No problems getting out of the back of this. Not at all. How'd you like it?
Nice.
I thought you might.